Honorable Chairperson, Excellencies, distinguished delegates, participants, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning, good afternoon to you all. In this 10-minute time, I will not be able to tell you what I wanted to say. Our chairperson is very much strict on her decision of 10 minutes time. So I will speak what 10-minute time limit permits me. So we have prepared a country paper with details, information about our experience, about our activities, and details that we will try to hand over to you tomorrow, to all the delegates of the different countries. So I think that will help you to know about details about us. I'm extremely honored and delighted to be here in this historic city of New Delhi to attend this conference of women's literacy for inclusive and sustainable development. I would like to convey my deep appreciation and heartfelt thanks to the Government of India for their warm reception and gracious hospitality extended to me and my delegation. Today is the 45th International Literacy Day. We are engaged both nationally and internationally to eradicate illiteracy and to ensure education for all. On this day, I congratulate all who are engaged in this struggle against illiteracy. Especially, I thank the Government of India for organizing this conference, and also I thank UNESCO for their cooperation. The awards for successful works for literacy which are given today will inspire others for more works and success. I consider this international conference of E9 countries and SAARC countries, education ministers, which will create a positive atmosphere for cooperation of the countries in the field of education. I will request you all, and particularly the organizer of this conference, India, will take further initiative for such conferences and such meetings. As ensured in our constitution and the vision projected by the father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, education is regarded as the principal means to attain national development goals. The present government, led by the Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina, is committed to build a happy and prosperous nation free from hunger, poverty, illiteracy, and corruption by 2021, what she called the Vision 2021. Our unwavering objective is to open a new horizon in the area of education through positive changes at all levels of the system, essentially exploiting the advantages of modern science and technology is offering to us. We are place-bound to transform the country into digital Bangladesh, and we are fully conscious that this could only be achieved through necessary reformation and modernization of education system. The government has already developed a national education policy, which is now undergoing implementation. Ladies and gentlemen, the present government is determined to ensure the enrollment of all school-aged children by 2011 and to achieve complete literacy by the year 2014. I am happy to share with you that we have achieved a commendable success with regard to access to and gender parity, both in primary and secondary level education. At present, 99.34% of the school-aged children are enrolled to education. The gender parity index is 1.03 and 1.17 in primary education and secondary education, respectively. Result of the public examinations are also show gender parity. 60% quota is reserved for the female teachers, of which 50% is already achieved. But retention of the children in the primary schools and ensuring quality of education still remain a big challenge. For last 2 years, we are distributing free textbooks from class 1 to class 10. This year, we have distributed free 232 million textbooks. And also, we are supporting 40% of the poor students with stipend. Ladies and gentlemen, as you all know, quality education is strongly linked with quality teaching, curriculum, learning materials, and conducive environment. Various activities for the quality improvement in the education have been initiated under the Primary Education Project 2 at primary level and under Teaching Quality Improvement in Secondary Education Project and Secondary Level. Substantial focus has been given to training of teachers, trainers, and academic supervisors. Pro-student-based training and particularly teaching methods are being introduced to teachers to manage the class more efficiently and yet friendly manner. National Teachers Registration and Certification Authority has been set up to recruit quality teachers in non-government schools and colleges. Private University Law 2010 has been passed to accommodate more students at the tertiary level. Ministry of Primary Education in Bangladesh is in the process of restructuring teachers' training program. Currently held 12-month certificate in education training will be changed into 18-month diploma in education. We are going to launch it as pilot project in 7 divisional primary training institutes from July next year. The government has undertaken considerable measures for modernization of madrasa education, that is Islamic religion-based education. Ladies and gentlemen, as a part of the government endeavor to improve quality of higher education, the Ministry of Education has taken initiative and various steps have been taken. Significant improvements in the students' performance are visibly reflected in the public examinations at various levels. Sustainable efforts are made in improving vocational and technical education and higher education to create a critical mass that would be competent to be global market. These achievements at the national level are contributing substantially to the attainment of MDG and IFA goals.
Thank you, Bangladesh. You have 2 minutes, so we'll appreciate if you summarize.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. I don't want to take much of your time. In Bangladesh, we have a large number of population, you all may know. We have 150 million population. So you can imagine, in a small territory, we have the main force is our population. So we want to prepare them with knowledge and skill. And so we are giving all our efforts to build our people with knowledge and skill. Then our human resource development, if we can develop our human resource, then we will be able to proceed. So our all-out effort is for education. We share your experience. We hope from this conference we will learn more and we will be able to work furthermore. And I tell you before, that we will distribute tomorrow about details of our education. I will not take much time, more time than 10 minutes of our chairperson. Thank you, chairperson. Thank you all.
Thank you very much. Thank you.